Welcome to the EverydayDrinkers.com podcast. I'm your host, Derek Schomer. Today, we're going to cover martinis, but not just any martinis. No gin, no vermouth. These are going to be vodka martinis, chocolate vodka martinis. You can't go wrong. Very sweet, great after-dinner drink. We're going to use a Three Olives chocolate vodka, which has a little martini logo, so you know it's going to be made for martinis. We've got our classic martini glasses. This kind of makes you look a little higher end, a little proper. And we're going to need Parrot Bay cocoa, or Parrot Bay coconut rum for one of the recipes. There'll be two recipes total. Creme de menthe. Can't go wrong with that. Creme de coco for one of our recipes. So what we're going to do is the Crazy Cow martini and the mint chocolate chip martini, which both these recipes you can find at threeolives.com. I just kind of boosted them up in level so that they would fit in a higher-end martini glass. You'll notice these are a little larger than a standard martini glass. It holds about 8 ounces right up to the brim, which is a little much, so we're not going to go that intense. Shaker, you always need a shaker. Throw some ice in there. Now, the trick with martinis is you should frost the glass. Put them in the freezer for a couple hours if you're having a party. Throw them in there all day, as many as you're going to have or need. Just stick them in there. If you're going to have a couple, you're going to want a new one each time because martinis don't have ice in them. They only have ice in the shaker and the frosted glass. You could frost the bottle, put it in the freezer for a couple hours or a day, or just always leave them in there. Vodka won't freeze, so that's a good idea. What we're going to need is, let's just start with a mint chocolate chip martini. You're going to want 3 ounces of chocolate vodka. This is a 1 ounce measuring, so we'll do three of these. One, two, three. 1.5 ounces of creme de menthe. That's going to give us the mint flavor. The end result is going to be what can only be explained as mint chocolate chip ice cream. Do one half. And a 1.5 creme de coco. Put the top on. Shake it up. Gotta keep the strainer on, because remember, no ice in your martini. You can smell them in from here. Put the tops on. Nice and foamy. Now what you could do is if you really want to impress people, you can garnish this by putting in a little stick, like a toothpick with a Hershey Kiss on it. Drop that in there, a stick of chocolate. You can round it with like maybe Hershey syrup. It kind of gets a little muddy when you do that, so you got to do it really carefully. Let's give it a try. Minty. Very good. You'll notice it doesn't taste a bit like alcohol. It tastes like mint chocolate, maybe a mint chocolate chip ice cream. Not as much vanilla, of course. There is a vanilla vodka. You can use vanilla vodka if you're going for more of a vanilla taste. So that's recipe number one. Now let's move on to recipe number two. That way we can get out of here. So we're going to have Crazy Cow martinis. Now this is, it is kind of insane. This one's going to have 2 ounces of our chocolate vodka, 1 ounce of the coconut, and 1 ounce of Irish cream. So we could use regular Irish cream, but we're going to kick it up a notch. We're going to use Irish cream caramel edition. You can buy this at the store. There's like 4 flavors of Irish cream. Now you're going to end up with something that's going to look a little bit like a heavily creamed coffee. It's going to taste really good. So let's do our 2 ounces here. One, two, Throw a little more ice in there. Since you're straining it out, can't go wrong. 1 ounce of the caramel. Ice cream taste smells like coffee. Awesome. 1 ounce of coconut. Now you can use any brand you want. I just happen to have this for, what do we make with this? Coke, no. We use mango. Mango Pirate's Bay for mojitos. What do we use for? I think coconut, oh, pina coladas. Most of this has been used on pina coladas. So I had it handy. It called in the recipe. Figured I'd give it a try. Shake it up. If you're making a lot of these, I suggest doubling the ounces to get yourself a larger glass that you could pour multiple at once, but you know, that's enough for me. I've already got two to drink here. So this is your Crazy Cow. You'll notice it looks like a very much like a cream coffee. It smells like a caramel coffee, something you get from Starbucks or Dunkin' Donuts if you're from the north side, northeast. Very sweet, a little sweeter than the mint chocolate, believe it or not, but it's still got a great taste. Very much an after-dinner drink, something you can have for dessert. This is like ice cream. That's pretty close to ice cream. Completely different contrast color. Awesome beverages. If you're into martinis, you want to try martinis, but you don't like gin or you don't like vermouth, this is the next best thing. If you're a guy and you're ordering them at a bar, might be a little weird. But if you're having a big party, not a bad idea. I'm your host, Derek Schomer, for EverydayDrinkers.com. We're teaching you how to drink.